Ladies and gentlemen, as announced by the captain, we just started our descent into Brussels.
Today, I will try to solve one of the last problems of my theory. Flight routes. How did we end up on this little blue ball, flying in space? Crucial in this story are two curses, two spells, two mathematical constructions.
Ah, caramba!
The first one is Columbus.
Ah, caramba!
And the second one is Mercator. Let's reverse engineer the mathematical tricks they are playing on us. The first question, of course, we have to ask is, do we have a real map? Therefore, let's investigate the information I gathered over several years. So, as you realize by now, I hope, we are living in a crater on the moon. The moon, of course, is a reflection of the bigger Earth. The first map that fitted into the crater was the United Nations map. But then I started to investigate Antarctica. I took a print screen of Sulpicius Gallus M, our crater on the bigger Earth. I made a 3D Photoshop of it, and to my surprise, one half of the crater was Antarctica. Bye bye, United Nations map. In came Uncle Walt, Walt Hitler. Because Disneyland is a perfect copy of our crater, with continents. And that brought me to the Tom Sawyer Island map. There I discovered that the continents are at a completely different position than we are being told. It seemed like the continents on the Tom Sawyer map were fitting in the crater. Next thing I discovered was the Ibn al-Wardi crater map. This map seems to be confirming the Walt Disney map. Again, the Americas lying at the wrong place. Next, I started to investigate some space images. Okay, I know, NASA are liars. But even liars sometimes have to tell the truth. And again, these images seem to confirm the position of the Americas. Big question, are the Americas inverted? And then, of course, I discovered these images of SpaceX. Thanks a lot, Elon. Soon it will be payday. On these images, you can clearly see Mount Meru. The Americas. And then, the big problem is, what about Africa and Eurasia? Because if I want to investigate the flight routes, I have to know the exact position. So let's recapitulate. We live in a crater. Antarctica is half the crater. In Antarctica, we have Mount Meru. you have the Ice Wall and the Americas. Let's take a look at our crater, the center point, Mount Meru. Notice the circular sea. Zoom in for the shape of the Americas. The SpaceX map. On the crater map. Then we have the ice wall surrounding the Americas. The SpaceX version. So the question now is, what is the exact shape of the other continents? Let's compare the Ibn al-Wardi map, SpaceX, Disney map, and print screen of our crater. The problem, of course, is that we see these continents in a certain perspective. So I cannot give you a 100% solution. Maybe one day I'll get some more evidence. But if this is the solution, then we have no Pacific Ocean. But if it is the Snowpiercer solution, then we have a Pacific Ocean. But let's build on the information we have. Let's start with one of the big mysteries. Why airplanes don't fly straight.
Captain, can you take more of a beeline to get me from New York to Berlin? So it begs the question, why is the flight path always so curved? Simple, the Earth is round. Maps are flat, unlike the actual planet, which is a sphere. So, the route a plane flies will usually look curved. If you were to look at the same path on a globe, however, it would look straight. These straight flight paths that look curved on a map are ironically known as great circle routes. They account for the curvature of the Earth. So, what may look like an unnecessary detour over Canada's east coast when you're looking at a flat map is the shortest path when flying. Okay, sorry, Captain, now I get it.
Okay, sorry, Captain. No, I don't get it. Let's say you want to fly from Moscow to Los Angeles in a straight line. So what this guy is telling us is because the Earth is round, you will take a completely different route. Alleluia! So you have a 2D map with a 2D flight. But what they are doing, they are putting a 3D flight on a 2D map. If you want to calculate a 3D route, you have to put it on a 3D map. And in that case, the route is exactly the same.
Ah, caramba!
The lie is so complicated that only stupid people understand the truth. I remember from my flat earth days that all these curved routes were actually straight lines on a United Nations map. The problem with the United Nations map is that it is circular. Let's warp it into our crater. And now we are close to my map. Let's do some exercises. If you want to recreate this flight pattern, this would be the position of the continents. What about this one? Same result. But let's fly in from the other side. It seems to be working. The only problem is that you are flying over Greenland. So you could make a little detour. But Greenland is still at the wrong place. Take another one, JFK to China. Again, the Greenland problem. Well, if this map is correct, I have two problems. One, I always said that the Americas were inverted. And two, Eurasia Africa has to be rotated. An interesting case, of course, is Australia. What if you want to fly from Australia to South America? Two possibilities on the little blue ball. Here it is shown on a Mercator map. So, two possibilities. Follow the ice wall in the north. Follow Antarctica in the south. Flying in a straight line would be giving away the real map. What do you mean? Are all the pilots in a conspiracy? So the first trick is the Columbus trick. Close the map and unfold it in the other direction. The discovery of the Americas. The second trick, divide the map in two. Insert two pyramids, and from there you create two half balls. It were not the Egyptians using the measurements of the earth to create their pyramids. It was Mercator using the pyramids to create his false scale model. From that moment you start seeing the double circle world maps. Next step, invert one of the balls and put them together in one gigantic ball. Create the Solomon system. Abracadabra. Mercator, Merkaba, Taurus projection. How does this work in flight routes? Let's say you want to fly from India to Central America on a flat earth. Insert the half balls. Next, you do a projection upwards and downwards. Gives you this graphic. Remember this one? 100 years to solve an integral. The integral of the second is well known to any beginner's calculus student. It was first introduced by Gerardus Mercator, who needed it to make his famous map in 1569. No, lies, dirty lies. Remember, a good friend of Mercator was John Dee. Let's visualize this on two halves. When you go from one side to the other, you make a Möbius ring. So are the pilots in the conspiracy? No, of course not. They have been indoctrinated with algebra. Al-Karaba.
Ah, caramba!
Center of this parasitic lie, of course, is London. Britannia rules the waves. It starts with John Dee and Mercator. But more tools are created to put us in the matrix. They give us the prime meridian in London, longitude and latitude. They claim they give you straight lines, but in reality they are curved. And in the meantime they keep selling us their BS.
It's extreme and we approach the pole. Clearly it's shorter to go over the pole itself, rather than following around the parallel of latitude. So it may seem like we're taking a strangely curved path, but actually we are following the shortest path on the surface of a sphere. In navigation, we call it a great circle track, and it works between any two points on the surface of the Earth.
So if you have a beard and glasses, and you have millions of viewers, you must be very clever. But wait, what about the ice wall? This problem is solved by discovering Antarctica in 1820. Circumnavigating the ice wall is circumnavigating Antarctica. And then the final problem, of course, what about the compass? Well, the Earth makes a lot of movements, but the most important one, they forgot to tell you. If the moon is the reflection of the bigger Earth, then our crater is making an 8 form every 24 hours. The constant movement of the water in an 8 form is creating a magnetic center, the North Pole, situated near Greenland. So, how will we know the real map? If you are a mathematical genius, maybe you can demarcate the map. So before I go, let me draw your attention to Martin Vreeland, Dutch researcher. Has some very interesting articles. Full-time investigator, so he deserves your attention. Then we have Harry from the Crater Boys with a very nice last video. Links will be in the description box. About myself, the only platform I'm on is YouTube. The only way I communicate is through the YouTube videos and through my mail, which is wimdegrotekunstenaar@gmail.com. My Facebook is personal, and for people who think they are communicating with me on other platforms, well, that's not me. Bye.